Well, I want to thank all of you for joining us on this season of Furuno Connections. This has been pretty exciting for all of us, and it was a pretty big undertaking to try and bring all of this product comparison together and get it to execute the way it did. It was really a flawless set of testing where we were able to do an apples-to-apples test on all four systems. And we tested the radar, we tested the chart plotter, the MFD itself, we looked at the fish finders, and also the 3D scanning multi-beam sonar. And all in all, I have to say that I think the TZtouch3 stood out above the rest. And it may seem a little biased on our part, but it really, when you take a look at that and go through and see how the test resulted, I'm hoping that you felt the same way. So what I want to do just to wrap up the season is just give each of you a chance to talk about what is your favorite or surprising piece of TZtouch3 that stood out to you this entire week. So Tim, I'll start with you.
All right, so Jeff, you know what? It's kind of hard to say it surprised me. I was impressed by a lot of things, but today when we were bouncing around from boat to boat, I got to go on all four boats, and I got to show everybody Nav Center Weather, which is a free weather service, you know, we offer through the TZT3. And once I put it on all four captains' boats, I got nothing but positive responses from everything. You know, it's just such an amazing free feature that gives you so much information. And all these guys, you know, they're professional fishermen. It's all information that they need that's great information. So, I mean, I just really can't say enough about it. And I, you know, hope to hear more from the captains about exactly, you know, now that they've started using it, what they think about it as well.
Excellent. Good point. Nav Center Weather.
It is pretty amazing. Yep.
All right, Captain Cam.
Yeah, so for me, my favorite feature that I enjoyed was the new event mark button in the top left-hand corner of the screen. That's something that I'll be able to use fishing day in and day out, finding new spots, getting new catches on off of old spots. So very effective, cool thing I found.
So. Awesome. Captain Jack.
Tell you what, Furuno hit the home run. You know what? They finally made the units easy. It's the easiest one of all. The GPS is easy, the radar is easy, the fish finder is easy, the edge swipes, the automatic mode, everything about it is easy, it's faster. I mean, there's no other comparison. I mean, it's amazing. So, bottom line, Furuno's easy.
Right on. Captain Mike, how about you?
I'd say my favorite part about TZtouch3 was definitely the fact of that I can download weather onto these units and have that right at my fingertips. You know, it's no more of you know, looking at the news the next day, checking my phone for weather apps, all this. I can physically get that right onto my TZtouch3 and have that right at my fingertips, right there, right while I'm fishing, right in the middle of everything. And it just alleviates a lot of stress and keeps you moving forward to catch good fish.
Great. Excellent. Captain Manny, how about you?
Just like the guys are saying, the weather that you can download, that's everything I ever wanted. But I also like the radar where you can lock this on a target and it will follow it. That, to me, is amazing also because none of that, that's all very innovative, all new. And before you have to have all these different systems to have it where you now have a unit that has it all in one. Built in, easy to use, and it looks amazing. It really blew me away.
That's awesome. Thank you. All right, Braden, from your side.
Mine's definitely got to be the edge swiping. You know, we had edge swipe in TZT2, but the way we're utilizing it now with TZT3 is, you know, it's just another step above. You know, the swipe up, whether, you know, if you're on your radar or your sounder, now that swipe up is completely dedicated to that page. And there's so much useful information on that swipe up that the angler or the captain would need, and it's right at their fingertips with one button push. Where on some of these other units, we were finding it was 2, 3, 4, sometimes 6 button pushes away was that information. So definitely the edge swiping, you know, the swipe down, how you set your favorite pages or your favorite hot pages now, and it's just like an old car stereo that I remember doing. And you just hold down on what page I'm on, you know, being able to jump around like that, all that information just so close to you. You know, it was just a great feature, such an improvement, you know, over TZT2.
That's awesome. Matt, Yeah, how about you?
One thing I really liked was the hybrid control system. I mean, we went out one day and it got pretty rough, and we were bouncing around pretty good there. And you know, just how easy it is to use and to get from where you need to go. Obviously, you know, theme of the day is quick and easy. So yeah, that was my favorite.
All right, Clayton.
You know, I think my favorite part of the whole thing has got to be the UI, because you know, that's the foundation on which the MFD, the system itself, is built. So if your foundation is terrible, you don't have a good system. That makes everything else either hard or easy. So if you can't get that right, that's where the battle is won and lost. So for us to have a UI that's so easy to, you know, just point and click and you're done, or find your way, wander through menus, and we know because we've been using the other system for a week, you know, it's no context. You know, it's just not even no context. It has to be the UI.
Yeah. Eric, how about you? You were part of the product development team.
Yeah, exactly. So we spent a lot of time on the UI, obviously, you know, and I will say that I was happy with what these guys found, you know, especially Captain Jack coming back and saying, boom, this is awesome, this is awesome. You know, I will say that our competition is formidable, you know, everybody's got a solid product, I think, but from an overall package perspective, from where these guys fish, the deep water aspect, the deep water capabilities of the DFF 3D multi-beam, the radar, you know, the down sounder, the true chirp echo sounder, the dual channel that we put in the system now into every MFD, combine that with the UI, combine that with the weather features, combine that from a complete package, and I'm really happy where we're at. I think we're going into 2020 with solid products, you know, and we're I just don't think that it, like what these guys said, is that when you combine everything together, you look at everything, we have the best system, the Furuno system, TZtouch 3, with our sensors, and everything in there is the best system.
So, well, yeah. Good job on development.
It isn't just me, it was a team of people. We worked hard, you know, we looked at what everybody else had. We tried to keep the keystrokes to a minimum. How quickly can you use that edge swipe? How quickly can you turn on and off targets, you know, tracks, you know, even today, looking at the tides and the currents. That was something that was just really useful to you, that you really, you had to like hunt for in a lot of the other products, and boom, it was right there at your fingertips, so.
I agree. Well, and the beauty of TZtouch 3 too is that we have three different size displays. We have a 12 inch, a 16 inch, and a 19 inch. So it will fit literally any size boat that's out there that needs a MFD like this. So whether it's a sailboat or a power cruiser or a sport fishing center console, this unit is perfect for any of those situations, and you can customize it on a building block system for what you want, whether you want a radar, whether you want AIS, whether you want to have the fishfinder or even the deep impact to go way down deep. All of that is available with TZtouch 3 to make the system that you need and customize it for what your specific need is on that. So I want to thank you for joining us on this journey that we took on the product comparison here. It was a lot of fun. Hopefully you had fun watching us doing this. And please share this with your friends, because there is a lot of information here that we spent a lot of time pulling out for you to be able to make the decision that makes the most sense for you. Whether it's a retrofit or a new build, this is the kind of stuff you need to know. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like, subscribe, and click on the bell below to get notifications for the next time we release new videos. Thanks a lot, and we'll see you next time.